Running out a little late. Weather's nice this morning, a little fog outside. We reported some fish down by the slide in about 30 fathoms. A lot of small fish, a few big ones mixed in. One thing about fishing in Santa Cruz, you mouth the harbor here to the fishing grounds is less than 20 minutes to a half hour. For most places you have to drive for 2 hours to get out to fishing grounds. Saves a lot of fuel, however the fishing, commercial fishing in Monterey is leaves a little bit to be desired. It's not really conducive to making a living. Early in the season when it starts out, it's pretty good. Boats out today, Sunday. This time of day is just beautiful. flopper scoppers, we call them, that Leroy just dropped in the water, keeps the boat from rocking. Have one on each side. It's like a stabilizer. Plastic donut with a line through it. They put a little half hitch on it around the wire that has two little brass fittings crimped on the wire.
Sure.
Works out very well. Then it goes out and hangs off the pole there and off the spring, so the fish gets pumping. It spring pulls and they call it pumping, and then you get a fish on.
Two stops out.
Snapping the leader on the downrigger. That 25-pound ball takes it down pretty deep. Now he's snapping on the float to float the downrigger out away from the boat and separate from the other downrigger. We have three downriggers on this, three on each side, and they float the lines back at different depths usually where the fish are till you find them, then you fish all of them at that depth. And they're set so they angle away from the boat so they don't stay right in the wake of the boat, they're outside. It works out pretty well. You have approximately 3 to 6 liters on each float. Brad's checking the medium ball. It's about a 35-pounder. And I don't think we have any fish on, but he's got a little snatch block rig here in the middle of the center of the boat here that makes it real nice so it doesn't tangle that outside one over there. When they come in, they cross over with your 10, 12 foot leaders, they could tangle very easily, but that's a real nice rig he has there set up. Commercial fishing is a lot of work. Constant checking your lines, pulling your float lines in and out, and back and down, up and down, up and down. These hydraulic systems here make it very, very nice.
I'm not on this one if you call me for some ungodly reason. Try channel 10 on the regular TV. I'll just bounce back and forth there a little bit, see what the hell those guys keep the attention to anything there or not. Okay, audio.
Recorder is really throwing a lot of bait. Should be some fish in this area. Hey, nice fish. Very nice. Oh! There we go. ago. Takes a while, but soon find them. And it cuts the gill, so when it hits them with that pipe there, all it does is knock them cold, and the little part will still keep beating, and all the blood will run out of the fish, which makes the meat last longer.
Getting right up here.
Yeah. That's a radar alarm that tells the fishermen that there's a boat within a certain distance. They set it for whatever distance they feel is safe. And happened to be a boat out in front of us here, about 300 yards, looks like.
Straight off to the our port bow. There he is.
When the fishermen are working off the stern of the boat, they aren't really aware of what's out in front of them, so that's a real safety factor when they're fishing out here. Here's what they look at in the radar. See a little reflection there, it's not too good, but the blip out there off our starboard side there, the right-hand side, shows the boat out there, the solid white. And that's what set the alarm off a few minutes ago. Time out. Yeah, Brad fished that boat for
Dog line too. Wow.